Hi, and welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Will Warren, and today we're going to be talking about the fifth wheel toy hauler, the Tesla 3970. Now, a lot of manufacturers out there don't tell you this, but if you live inside of a camper, whether that camper is a pop-up, whether that camper is a travel trailer, a fifth wheel, a toy hauler, fifth wheel, whatever the case is, and by living, I mean staying even just a few months in it, you will typically void your warranty. Now, Tesla is a high-end quality fifth wheel toy hauler, and you can live inside this thing and you don't void your warranty at all. As a matter of fact, they believe in their product so much, this comes with a 3-year structure warranty. Now, how is this possible? It's through Tesla's unparalleled quality. The Tesla product is made with a powder-coated Lippert I-beam frame. This frame is so strong that after the weight of the camper is added to it, you still have 4,000 pounds left over for cargo. The sidewalls here are what you call a vacuum bonded sidewall product. Now, what is vacuum bonding? Well, it's the opposite of what most people in the industry do, called pinch rolling. Pinch rolling is how the industry got started making fiberglass walls. You take a piece of Luon, you take a piece of fiberglass, you put glue in the middle, and both of those get crushed through a series of rolling pins as it shoots through, and that bonds it together. The problem is, in that bond, there's still some air left in there, and that causes that glue to degrade, and that fiberglass begins to peel away. So vacuum bonding is more expensive, but it's 10 times less likely to delaminate. This wall here has the same ingredients: Luon, fiberglass, and glue, put on a stacking press. That press comes down and it presses the wall, the entire wall, at the same pressure constantly. That does two things. It works the glue deeper into the fiberglass, deeper into the Luon. It also pushes out any of the air left in that bond, hence the term vacuum. And this entire coach is vacuum bonded. Up here on the roof, if you can see up there, you can see how the roof wraps around the side of the camper. That roof is a fully radiused roof, meaning it sheds water out like a dome does. And then that wrapping keeps leaks to a minimum as well. Now, that's just a little bit of the quality of the Tesla product. On the outside, they are feature loaded. In this compartment right here, I have a 5.5 Onan's Cummins generator. Directly to my left is a trail air suspension pin box that absorbs a lot of the up and down motion as you're driving down the road with this. You have two electric awnings on this coach with LED lights beneath. You have outside speakers which can be controlled from a console on the main slide in the middle there. You have 4 steps instead of 3 steps up into your main living area. And just about nobody has as much storage as a Tesla. A lot of guys, the vertical storage is cut off by the frame coming up to here. But in the Teslas, they drop down the frame and you get all of this storage. Down here, you can see some of the insulation that they put in here that reflects the cold or the heat back into your coach. Nobody puts this insulation up here in the fifth wheel portion of a fifth wheel, whether it's a toy hauler or just a regular residential. You also have bonded, frameless automotive windows that are dual pane, and a 6-point auto level system. When you get to where you're going in a Tesla, you can just press a button and the camper will level itself out. Well, we've talked a little bit about some of the construction qualities and some of the features the Tesla has on the outside. Let's go on the inside and see what we can find out in there. So this is the inside of the Tesla 3970. And as you can see, it doesn't look like your everyday run-of-the-mill toy hauler. The Tesla is designed to give you 3 things in one. 1, obviously, to haul your toys. 2, to practically sleep a small army. And 3, you can live in it comfortably. For sleeping arrangements, you have a king-size bed in the bedroom. You have, directly on the back of the kitchen, a loft area. In the garage area, you have 2 couches that fold down into 2 separate beds, as well as a queen bed above that. For living in a Tesla, like we covered earlier, you can live in this without voiding your warranty. The insulation package in this Tesla is impressive. You have R38 in the ceiling, R38 in the floors, and your windows are dual pane. And as far as comfort goes in a Tesla, it has no comparison. leather couches on both sides with recliners on this one here, a 50-inch TV, an inside stereo system, touchscreen with kicker audio. And if you look back here, opposite of the kitchen, you have a massive pantry, as well as a two-door, 12 cubic foot gas electric refrigerator. This will also run off of your propane in case you are parked away from power. Or if you want to, you can always fire up again that 5.5 Onan generator and run it off electricity that way. Moving over to the kitchen, you have real Corian countertops, LED lit sides on those countertops, a high-rise stainless steel faucet, removable covers, and a stainless steel sink. So you don't have to melt through your plastic sink like in some models if you put a hot pot in there. You have a regular sized microwave, not a dinky RV sized microwave, three burner stove, oversized oven. This has the deeper storage in it compared to a lot of other ovens out there. And of course you have a lot of storage. Now, let's take a look in the garage so I can show you a few of the features of the Tesla's garage. Here we're in the Tesla garage, and you can't see it because we skipped to this section here, but as you walk in from the kitchen into the garage, one of the things you would notice is there's no step down into the garage. It's a flush floor from the garage into the living section of the Tesla. And this is important because in the middle of the night, if you have to come back here for something, you don't want to be tripping either into the living area or out of the living area into the garage. Now, the other thing that's unique about a Tesla product is that there is 3 inches of insulation below my feet here. Underneath the subfloor, Tesla's the only company that puts three inches of insulation under the subfloor. Most guys call it a day after they throw decking directly onto the frame. And so there's no insulation in your garage floor. That's another thing most manufacturers will not tell you. You also have your dual pane windows in the back here and R38 insulation up in the ceiling again. Now, in the Tesla product, you also happen to have heavy duty tie downs on the floor. You have diamond plate that runs up the sides. A lot of guys will only put up to 4 to 6 inches of diamond plate on there. That doesn't do you a lot of good if your four wheelers end up rubbing against the sidewalls of your camper. Behind me, you'll notice an extra little fridge for beverages, a storage shelf for helmets, coats, jackets. Directly above me is another LED TV. Obviously, you've seen the table and the two couches on the side of us here. What you don't see is directly above us is that queen bed for extra sleeping that can be brought down whenever needed. So here we are on the deck of the 3970. And as you can see, we've set it up with the patio. Now, of course, this can still be used to drive your toys inside. Simply by swinging the part of the patio here inward, you can drive your toys up into it. You also happen to have a very mellow dovetail, or how should I say this? The dovetail on the Tesla product is longer than most, meaning it doesn't have quite the angle that a lot of others do. Why did Tesla do this? Specifically for the person who wants to put their Goldwing in a camper like this, or some other type of vehicle that has a very low clearance that would high center on traditional campers, where the angle of the dovetail is very, very steep. You also happen to have storage in the dovetail as well. And directly above us is an awning that you can put out to shade both the deck area and the garage. And something that's also pretty unique to Tesla is that if you wanted to get off the deck, but say there's everybody playing a card game or eating here at the table, you don't have to have them all move to get out of the way. Instead, you can open up the gate right here with an additional step that's been added so you can exit off the patio. This is the bedroom of the Tesla 3970. Right here, you have a TV. You also happen to have drawers here, cupboards right here for clothes. They automatically close. And in a Tesla, all of your drawer faces are gonna be raised panel real wood. You have a king size bed from the Denver Mattress Company. Your AC is ducted up in the bedroom as well, as is your speaker system. And directly behind me, we have a large cedar plank closet with plenty of room for your clothes. Well, again, thank you for watching our video. I hope that we can talk soon and you can learn more about the Tesla. There's a lot that I didn't cover in this video, so if you're interested, please give us a call. Again, my name is Will. I work at the Great Outdoors RV Company in Evans, Colorado. Our number here is 970-313-4337. That's 970-313-4337. Thank you.